Welcome back to learning about the Trinitarian Church. It's been 5 months since we had our last class. So I know what we did 5 months ago, but I think it would be a good thing to review things and also to ask a number of questions. One question that I had for everybody was, were you here when the Archbishop was here? Yes. My first question was going to be for the group was, did they have any questions about when the Archbishop came and ordained a deacon or ordained a subdeacon, any liturgical questions, any kind of questions about the singing and everything, but two out of three were people. Actually, Sister, you were here.
For the last class? No.
No, for the when Archbishop came.
Yes, indeed I was.
Yes, so you weren't here. You weren't here. That's right, you weren't even here. That's right. So one person can figure. Any questions, Sister? She has
no questions. No.
She's jealous.
Not in the camera. No.
Okay. Gotcha. So that would have been my first thing. Okay. Well, let's go over a review of how this class is really about how the church services work. Yeah, we're going to do some singing and everything, and people are going to, you know, get on the internet. A couple of people have done that and said, you know, Father, there's a great class on the internet that's taught by so-and-so, you know, and it's really good and everything else. I said, well, you can do that too if you want, and you probably get a better understanding of music. But one of my goals with this class is for us to understand how the services work, how they're put together, and then music, how that comes together. So we do that through the eight tones. And these have been developed over the years in monasteries mostly. And the tones that we use today come out of the Russian Empire, out of the middle of the last part of the 1800s. And they were used in Kiev and Moscow. They became the common tone. So whenever you see that written in a book, the common tone is it's the common tone. So this is what we'll be talking about directly, is the common tone of the church. And there are lots of names for it, language protocol, keeping tone. Oh, the one we did at my home parish, that's my favorite one. Yeah. it's the common tone. So there are eight tones, which are different melodies, but within each tone, there are two or three subsets, and they have to do with our services. So the first subset in all eight tones is the Troparia, and that's the song that we sing that's specific for a feast day, like Christ is risen from the dead, trampling down death by death upon the life. That's Troparion for Easter. That's the Troparion for the elevation of the cross. That was just singing tone. What that tone was. So the first subset in the tone are Troparions and Kantakions. Whenever you say Troparion so-and-so, and then a bunch of text, it's supposed to go into that tone. It's Troparion tone 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So Troparion tone 1 for Sundays is very simple. And the stone had been sealed by the Jews. If you turn to page, this is what we sang today, because today is tone 5 day. rotate through each week. So let us lift fearful praise and worship the Word, O eternal with the Father and the Spirit. So that's tone five. And we sing that virtual part in the Now, you can find all of these in the back of the Vestments book, but also there's a lot of fireworks too that have been written. Or you can do what I do, which was I sort of didn't know how to read music in 1976. I sort of learned how to read music the hard way. And I sort of picked it up after a year, and I don't know how I picked it up so quickly. So I don't know if it was a talent or whatever. But I started like memorizing things. So that was 42 years ago, and 43 years ago, and I memorized lots of stuff back then, and I still know that. And it's not because I'm brilliant, I'm not, but for some reason I have that, I can memorize music very good. And so, which helps a lot. So today we had tone five, troparion and cantacion. We had another tone for special saint for today. And for Sunday Divine Liturgy, that's about it. Sometimes you'll hear the first and second part of the church service, the two antiphons, the first two of the Psalms, they'll be done in tone one. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Sometimes people say, well, do regular, this is really one of my favorite words in church music, regular tone one. That's what regular tone one is. And most people know that as they sing in choirs, is that you know what regular tone one is. You should know. So we sang that today. So we did a number of tones today, and then we did a number of special pieces of music that don't really have a tone. So the cherubic hymn. Those don't have necessarily tones. Those are separate pieces of music. We do in the Orthodox Church have people that have written an entire Divine Liturgy, or an entire Vespers, or an entire Vigil. These guys, most of them came out in the late 1800s. They were like Mark Mononoff and Tchaikovsky, and they might have heard of those guys. They wrote Divine Liturgies in Vigil Suite. And they technically base some of their things on the tones. He sort of sometimes did. So it's, you can sort of catch things in their music. So there is a Divine Liturgy of Tchaikovsky. There's a Divine Liturgy of Rachmaninoff. But to sing such a thing, you need a 120-person choir with eight different parts and people that read music. Singing choirs like that, and it's pretty extraordinary. But we don't have any. We have a small choir, small parish choir, with a choir director, thank God. And we sort of know the tones, which is what this class is for, to teach other people the tones. So that's sort of the introduction. Do you have any questions about tones and what they are and everything else? They're tunes. Mark, you can't, Mark, you can ask questions. I'm joking with you a little bit. Nope, he's not going to answer. Okay, you guys don't have any questions. Okay. So tone one, we already went over to Karin. So turn to page 22. This is the other major subset of tone one. it's called Lord I Call Terms, which is sort of weird because this is a song, Lord I Call, a song Lord I Call. And they didn't exist in other, it doesn't just say Lord I Call Tone. It doesn't really make any sense. It's the only place that it sort of exists. So we do it for Lord I Call. Do it for the Apostolica, which is another part of Esther's. Do it for parts of Matthew's. And then every once in a while, I might prick in something else. That's basically what it is. So that's, would you like a book?
What book?
Esther's book, so you can sort of follow along.
Oh, okay.
You turn to page 22. You don't want a book. You do want a book.
Thank you.
You're welcome. You can't keep it because actually, oh. you could keep it. Now there's two ways of doing tones. One, the old fashioned. Choir director does. She takes out her well-tuned harmonica and she will give us a tone. So so what often will happen is that there will be one person, usually it's Sal, sometimes it's me, that will be leading the choir, and we'll sort of tip it down a little bit. So instead of, so we'll go, Lord, I call upon thee, hear me, I took down the bird, hear me, O Lord. Lord, I call upon thee, hear me. Okay, so same tone, but tip it down a little bit. We basically do, when the choir's out here and the choir director is in here, we do group singing. One person is leading, and the other people sort of try and sort of follow along with that, right? But you have to know the tone of the week. If you don't know that, you won't have any idea what you're doing. Sometimes we get lost, and we do tone 9 or tone 10. They don't exist.
Yo.
Yeah, so it's not very good. So so this week, this is the tone that we used last time. Our church services start in the middle of that service, starts the next day. So this music is the music we did last night, it's for today. And this music goes on all week. So tomorrow, if we were to do Vespers tomorrow night, take out a load. And it would say, Monday, Vespers, tone 5. And there would be music. Anything specifically for that. Not Sunday things, there would be Monday things. And so on. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. There are festal things which have to do with minor feasts of the church, saints, saints' day. And some of these saints are important enough that they have their own, what I call tones, or and everything else, and they're in the Menan, it's called Menan, which means a monthly book. And there are 12 Menans, one for each month. So day probably was like a medium day. So there might have been, there was a little bit, I think two or three verses for the same person in the name. So we can add all kinds of, as far as services are 8 hours long. So that's how you put together a service. You figure out what kind of day it is, what's the tone of the day. So when Sal comes here, or when I come here, we already know these things. We can lead the choir, we can lead everybody together in some kind of semblance of order. So that's basically what we do. So we have term one. There's one other subset of term one, and that's the prokeimenon. The prokeimenon is where that announces the reading of the epistle, the Old Testament, or the gospel. And they all have terms. We rarely sing. There are in Prokeimenon for the days for Saturday, or like each day is in on day 68. Okay. But there's no music there. So how are you supposed to know this? Well, you can either take it from me or Monday night or do something tomorrow night. Better not try that. Anyway, each day has a different prokeimenon and has a different tone to it. Okay? So we know every Wednesday night, prokeimenon tone is 5. If you don't know it, what we do is we sing straight. One of them. We only encounter that during Holy Week and Easter is when we sing canons in the church. There are canon tones. We also encounter them when we do memorial services. That is a tone. A canon tone. So there are only 4 subsets. Are we too confused? Are we really confused? No? Yes? Any questions? Anybody? If we don't want to do that, I mean, if we don't want to do this, we can pick up something. We can, you know.
Okay, so Wednesday evening is 2:05.
Yes.
Regardless of the tone of the week.
Regardless of the tone of the week.
Only for the people.
Only for the people. Exactly. Yeah. I remember the really complex term of this. I don't remember the regular term for this.
What was that?
I remember, I'm trying to remember term 5, but I'm going to have to look it up. So.
And each tone ends with a different melody.
Each tone has its own melody. And group of texts for every day, every major, minor, major, and great feast. The bigger the feast, the more stuff there is. So we have a book called the Thestamenon, which is not, it's not 12 books, it's just one book. And it has all of the music for great feasts. So we have a great feast coming up on the 21st of November, presentation of Our Lady Virgin Mary into the temple, and the music will come out of there. Which tones there will be, what the royal call is, what the troparion is, and kandaki is, it all comes out of that book. Or, do you want to know how to do this easily? Because we can literally, I can literally bring out all the books and show you how to do this. It'll probably take about 5 or 6 months to learn how to really get it straight. The other way of doing it is you go on OCA.org, our church website, and you go to the 23rd of September, and you plug it in, and it says, Lord, I call. It gives you everything that you need. Apostica gives you everything that you need, the two main Chobari and Kentucky for the day. Everything that you need. This is what Sal does. This is what I do. I'll check sometimes to make sure it's right. But I don't take all the books out for each service. Because you press a button and go, oh, there they all are. And sometimes they even have the music. But they usually have the text. So if you want to know what's going on, that's what you do. You look up the date. Now, how that date's put together, that's different. Because that comes from another book called Rubrics. I have one of those on the altar, and there's one of them for the readers, and there's one for the choir director.
I think it's right there.
These are the rubrics for the church from the sheet. So they even start with liturgical calendar rubrics for 2019. So, in the beginning, it has our calendar for Easter and what's around us, what's going on this year and for the next 3 years, which is sort of cool. Then it has concerning fasting. People always ask, well, what should I fast? Basically, I give a truncated outline for this. Why do you wear weird color vestments in church, Father? Color vestments in church. Okay. Now, this isn't exactly right because there are some customs that here that a little bit different, but it's pretty close. All the great feasts of the church and other important feasts, also known as a major or minor feast, there's about 40 of them altogether. When are weddings not to be celebrated? Days for commemoration of the departed. They even have terminology.
Oh, nice.
What's great compline? What's compline? What's a kathisma? What does that mean?
Tell us.
Because we sing them all the time. I'll tell you. Blessed is the man that walks not in the wicked. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. What is that? It's tone one. It's the first confessional. We sing it in every vestige. The Psalter is made up into 20 different parts, and that they're called confessionals in Greek and Russian. And that's the first one. Vespers is supposed to have at least three confessionals, the one confessional, and Matins is, we don't sing them anymore. We sing little pieces of them. So that's what a confessional is.
Could you tell us once again what apostica is?
Apostica is just a part of Vespers, and it's rarely also sung in Greek common for two great feasts, for Christmas and in the other. But it's a group of hymns. It's a part of, actually, it's more than a hymn. It's like a super hymn. It's a part of Vespers. It's a whole part of Vespers. So it has its own stichiri, its own hymns to it. It has its own reading. It has its own verses to it. So if you look on page, really you look at it rather than talk about it. So on page 84, we magnify thee in songs of praise, O our Savior Christ. someone popped out and said, "The Lord is King, He is robed in majesty," on Saturday night is the verse for that. And then there are other verses too that separate these. There are five or six of these for the apostate. So the apostate is made up of that. That whole thing.
So did you call it the ending for the rest?
No, not yet. Still in the middle. Sort of middle, late middle. Can you imagine if people, some people in this parish, if I didn't have a phone? It's not what I wrote out. Stupid thing.
I'll look it up and say what it is next time.
Right, that isn't in English. How about English, please? What language is this? This is like...
McDonald's.
Is this like a real language?
I'm afraid to say that it's Romanian.
How do I get it into English? I don't know how to do this. Last thing that we hear of this word.
I know what he does. This is artificial intelligence. They think he wants a possible.
I know it does, but that's not what I put down. And I didn't misspell it either.
So it says in small print.
So it thinks that I don't know how to spell, number one.
Yeah.
Bad news. Liturgical terms, I do know how to spell. History things, I can spell Constantinople. That thing can.
Yeah. Are you kidding?
No.
Wow, that's pretty bad.
In order for the days of the week. How do you pick it, like tone one, and then it's tone five, and then it's tone
four? Okay, the more important something is, the more tones there's going to be. It's just a rule. Okay, it's like a custom that's become a rule.
Yeah.
So we should be rotating through the tones. You know, like this week should all be tone five, and everything should be tone five. It would be easier, right? But we're Orthodox. We didn't do anything. So we have, if we come up to a great feast, actually September 26th is the 26th. That's not the right one. Where is this thing? Okay, here's one. The 24th. So Tuesday, September 24th, we have a holy proto-martyr equal the apostles.
Tekla.
Somebody's name's day is Tuesday. So number one, big feast because of her. But number two, holy new martyrs of Alaska, a higher monkey Manali and Peter the Aleut. So these guys were the first Orthodox martyrs in Alaska, in America, period. So these are big things. So we look at great vessels, and it says, tone two, Lord, I call. Not tone five, tone two. It doesn't even tell you how many of the saints there are. I'm gonna have to look this up in the computer, because it's not even giving me the number of verses that I need to do for the saints. It is everything on the saints. So I'm going to assume it's Thecla and the two martyrs. So there's nothing for the day. There's nothing for Tuesday. All in the saints. That's for Lord I call. We have three. We have the Prokemon of the day, which we talked about already. Did you find out anything?
That's it.
You want to tell us what the apostle means? Sure. Go ahead.
Apostica, our hymn, sung between verses of selected psalms. Thus the Greek meaning hymns on the verses. Verses are stichos. Found at Vespers and at weekday Matins. They are unique in that they start with a hymn rather than a verse as stichera usually do.
Cool. So that's the answer to your question, right?
Yes.
Very good. So let's get back to St. Thecla.
Yeah.
So St. Thecla must have something to do with tone two. We have to tone two for St. Thecla. St. Mordecai, we have a prokimenon of the day, which we know because we look in here, and it has a prokimenon of the day in here. The day is Monday night. Apostica is all the saints, so there'll be things for the saints out of the Menaean. And the Troparia, which is the thing, first thing you learned about, would be for the saints, for the two different saints, the three different saints that we have, martyrs, and for that one. So we have to get the Menaean to get the saints. And that's it. It's going to come up. Almost everything out of the Vespers service will come out of the Menaean. The Troparia, we can talk in for the saints to be in the Menaean too. Those are the two big hymns that we sing during the Divine Liturgy for the feast. So that will be out of there too. So we need a Menaean. Or we just need orthodox.oca.com and just go pink. Like I said at the beginning, if you really want to learn the tones, and apparently we don't have a big group of people that do want to learn the tones, then the best thing for us to do probably is to get a group of people who learn well under computer circumstances. That's not me. I can help you. I can be here for that. But I can't teach you how to do it. It drives me nuts. I'm too old for that. Or I'm just smarter. But we can. could actually run tones that way if we wanted to. But this gives you an idea on how the church services work if your minds are too numb after our divine liturgy of things today. Okay? How's that sound? Let's go downstairs and eat some more food. Thank you.
Thank you.
We need a new topic.